Hey guys, I am super excited to show you how you can create a nice and simple photo slideshow animation inside of Adobe After Effects without using any third-party plugins. This is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's jump into the After Effects and get started. Alright, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and if you are watching this video first time on this channel, please hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button for this video. And now let's start by creating a new composition. So click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is gonna be the main composition, so let's call it main. Set the size of this composition, maybe 1920 in width, 1080 in height. You can go with 4K resolution as well. Now we have to select our frame rate. So in this case, I'm gonna use this 60 frame per second frame rate, but you can select 24 frame per second or 30 frame per second according to you. Let's set the duration of this composition maybe 5 seconds long, which is good enough for one slide. You can select the background color black, hit OK. Now we have to create one more composition, that is going to be the media composition, where we can drag and drop our image or video file. So just go to the composition, take a new composition, and this is going to be the media composition, so let's call it media. Leave the setting as it is, hit OK. And now we have to import an image or video file. So just go to your project window, just double click on this project window. I'm using this image that I have downloaded from unsplash.com. You can use any different image or video that you like. Select the video or images and click on import. Now we have to drag this image inside of the media composition just like that, and we have to fit this image, so hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Let's scale it down a bit and set the image according to the composition. Just go to your main composition and drag and drop the media composition inside of the main composition. Just go to the end of this animation, hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on a scale property. Go to very first frame of this animation. Let's increase the size of this image. So I'm going to set the value maybe 120%. And now we have a nice and simple zoom out animation, which is looking nice. Now you can close the layer, and we have to create a noise layer. So just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid layer. And this is going to be the noise. So let's call it noise. Hit OK. Now we have to apply an effect on it, so just go to effect and preset. If you don't have the effect and preset, just go to window and check this option effect and preset and search for fractal noise. So this is the fractal noise effect. Let's drag and drop on this solid layer, and here we have to do some basic setting. So just go to fractal type and set it to dynamic, go to fractal type and set it to block. Here we have the contrast and brightness, so let's set the contrast value maybe 60. Brightness negative 60. Here we have the complexity, so let's set the complexity maybe 1.2. Open the transform, and here we have the scale, so let's increase the scale value and set the scale value maybe 400. And here we have the evaluation, so we have to animate the evaluation. So what we have to do, I'm going to use a time expression on the evaluation, so it's very simple. Hold alt on the keyboard, click on the stopwatch button to open the expression box, and here we have to type a time expression. So let's type time multiply by 100. You can close the layer, and here we will get this type of animated noise. We have to blend the noise with the image, so it's very simple again. Here we have the blending mode. If you don't have the blending mode, you can click on the toggle switches, and let's set the blending mode add. And now we will get very interesting effect on the image. Select both the layers, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and this is going to be the image layer, so I'm going to call it image, hit enter. After that, we have to create a duplicate of the image, so hit Ctrl D to duplicate. Turn off the visibility of the top layer, select the bottom layer, and we have to apply some effect on it. So just go to effect and preset and search for tint. So this is the tint effect. Let's drag and drop the tint effect on the bottom image layer and make it black and white. Now just go to effect and preset and search for directional blur. So this is the directional blur effect. Let's drag and drop the directional blur on the bottom image layer. and select the bottom image layer, go to effect control, and here we have the blur length. So I'm going to set the value of the blur length maybe 50. Now you can increase the scale a little bit to avoid this black border around it. So select the bottom image layer, hit S on the keyboard. Let's set the scale value maybe 105. Now it's looking perfect. And select the bottom image layer, hit T on the keyboard to open the opacity. Let's set the opacity maybe 50 or 60% and make it like this. After that, you can turn on the visibility of the top layer, just like that. And finally, we have to create a shape over here. So select the rectangle tool, maybe rounded rectangle tool from here. Click on fill, set it to solid color. Click on stroke and set it to none. Now we have to create a rectangle, something like this. Now you can open the rectangle one, open the rectangle path one, and here we have the size. First of all, we have to unlink the width and height. So click on the button, and here we have to set the value maybe 260, height value maybe 850. Perfect. Now you can increase the roundness. So I'm gonna set the corner roundness maybe 30, and we will get something like this. Now you can close the shape layer. Select the shape layer, hold control on the keyboard, and just double click on the span behind tool to set the anchor point in the center of this shape layer. Select the move tool, go to align, and here we have to align the shape in the center. So click on the align horizontally, click on the align vertically. Now we have to create multiple copy of this shape layer. So select the shape layer, hit control D to duplicate, hold shift on the keyboard, press left arrow key, and set the shape just like that. Select the first shape layer, hit control D to duplicate, hold shift on the keyboard, press right arrow key, and place the shape over here maybe. Just like that. Now we have to make one more copy of this one. So select the layer, hit control D to duplicate, and place it over here maybe. Now we have to create one more duplicate of this layer. So select the shape layer 3, hit control D to duplicate, hold shift on the keyboard, press right arrow key, select the first one and leave it as it is. Select the second one, hold shift on the keyboard, press up arrow key 2 times, select this one, hold shift, press up arrow key 2 times, and set it like this. Now select this one, hold shift, press down arrow key 2 times, do the same thing with this layer. So select the layer 5, hold shift, press down arrow key 2 times, and make it like this, which is looking very interesting. Now select all the layers, go to on 1 second over here, hit P on the keyboard to open the position property, click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe, and lock the position value as it is at 1 second. Just go to on 3.5 seconds over here, click on the diamond button to add one more keyframe. On 3.5 seconds, go to 1 second forward in time, which is maybe 4.5 seconds, hold shift on the keyboard, press up arrow key, and move all the shape in upper direction, maybe outside of the frame, just like that. Go to very first frame of this animation, hold shift on the keyboard, press down arrow key, and placed all the shape outside of the frame in the lower direction. Just go to the center of these two keyframes, hold shift and press down arrow key 2 times maybe, select all the keyframes, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy ease them, go to your graph editor, highlight this point, hold this handle and set it like this, and create a nice smooth curve. Highlight this point, hold this handle and drag it like this, and create a nice smooth curve. And you can close the graph editor, go to very first frame, and let's have a look. And it's looking like this. Now we have to create a time gap between each shapes. So let's close the layer first. We have to create a time gap of 4 or 5 frames between each layers. So just place the CTI at 5 frames. Move the second layer over here and create a gap of 5 frames, just like that. And now it's looking much better. Perfect. After that, select all the layers, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and let's call it slides. Check this option, move all attributes into the new composition, hit OK. And I'm gonna use this slide as a mat for this colorful image. So Select the image, go to track matte and change the track matte to alpha matte. If you don't have the track matte, you can click on the toggle switches. And now we will get something like this. Now select the image and the slide layer, right click on that, click on pre-compose. And this is gonna be the colorful output. So let's call it color. Check this option, move all attribution to the new composition, hit okay. After that, we have to apply drop shadow effect on it. So just go to effect and preset and search for drop shadow. So this is the drop shadow effect. Let's drag and drop on the color composition, and we have to do some settings. So just go to the effect control, and here we have the softness. Let's set the softness value maybe 60 or 80, and let's reduce the opacity. So I'm gonna set the opacity 30%. Now it's looking perfect. You can see before and after. And now we have to add the stroke effect. So it's very simple again. Just go to project window, select the slides composition, hit control D to duplicate, right click on the slides composition, click on rename and call it strokes, hit enter. Let's drag and drop this stroke. Just double click on this stroke composition, open it up, select all the layers, click on fill, set it to none, click on stroke, set it to solid color, and you can set the stroke thickness maybe 3 pixel. Hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Let's scale it down a bit, set it to 90%. Perfect. Now you can go to the main composition, and here just go to the blending mode and change this to overlay. And finally, we will get something like this, which is looking absolutely perfect. And now we have to add a text. So just select the text tool. You can select your favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using Brownhill script. Set the size of the text maybe 250 pixel. Click over here and type anything whatever you want. Select the text layer, go to one second, select the move tool and place the text over here. Maybe hit P on the keyboard to open the position property, click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on position property and lock the position value at 1 second. Go to 3.5 second, click on the diamond button and lock the value as it is. Go to 1 second forward in time, 4.5 second, and let's drag the text in upper direction, maybe outside of the frame, just like that. Go to very first frame, let's drag the text outside of the frame, select all the keyframes, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor. If your graph editor not looking like this, then right click on that and click on edit a speed graph. And now highlight this point, hold this handle and just drag it like this and create a nice smooth curve. Highlight this point, hold this handle and just drag it like this. Now you can close the graph editor and let's have a look. All right, so it's looking absolutely perfect. And now we have to add one more effect. Select the text layer, go to effect and preset. Just drag and drop this shadow on the text layer, just like that. And here we have to increase the softness. So let's set the value maybe 50. And finally, we will get the final output. You can reduce the opacity of the drop shadow. So you can set the value maybe 30%. Now it's almost done. Let's do one more thing. Just click on the toggle switches, click on the motion blur button and turn on the motion blur for each layers. Just go to very first frame of this animation, go to full screen and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos. Also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikash and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.